Well, they made an incorrect assumption this morning by indicating that this massive cloud cover crossing over the Great Lakes was the Colorado low. It was not the Colorado low. So in broadcasting, whatever a mistake is made, it is corrected as soon as possible, and that's right here, right now. So I beg all of my audience members for forgiveness and hope that we can definitely move on and keep a good eye on this developing Colorado low spinning backwards furiously out of Colorado, moving across Montana and the Dakota states. There is that cloud cover moving with the jet stream from west to east, aiming towards the Great Lakes. And this thing is still forecasted to hit northeast Ontario with the vengeance, up to 30 centimeters of snow for the Kapuskasing-Hearst area, less than that for the Timmins-Cochrane area, with the possibility of mixed precip, freezing rain are still possible, all this and all that blowing around all together. If the slow pressure system comes and goes within 12 hours and there's still snow ahead of it for tomorrow night, this time tomorrow night, the winds behind it are going to be ferocious and our temperatures are going to plummet down. So the seasonally warm temperatures for today, well, they're going to go down slowly but gradually as the back end of the system does affect us. What went on for today, though, is that we had this passing disturbance. It's a low pressure system crossing over the Great Lakes at 1,007 millibars, which is okay. Enough to bring in the northeast winds across northeast Ontario, which shifted to the northwest, not a big deal. Warm front that produced plus-side temperatures for southern Ontario, freezing marker cooler from the Muskokas north towards here around northeast Ontario. Light snow all day for Kapuskasing, no reports of accumulations. Light freezing drizzle mixed with light snow for the Timmins area, which stopped for an hour with ice crystals around 8 o'clock this evening. And after 9 o'clock, the light snow picked up once again. In fact, the good news is our barometric pressure is on the way up because the slow pressure that's causing all of today's gray, humid, seasonally warm temperatures is showing signs of weakening as it continues moving eastward at about 20 kilometers an hour. This is a very long frontal boundary. It's a warm front stretching from the state of Maine all the way back towards Ontario, north of Michigan, and continuing on towards Illinois and Minnesota heading westward. So this could be the precursor or the leading edge of that Colorado low for Monday. We will keep an eye on our conditions for Monday morning, see how they develop into Monday afternoon. And we will be simulcasting on this Timmins Weather Channel group with the Timmins StormWatch group as conditions develop throughout the day on Monday. Thanks for tuning in to this apologetic broadcast. Here's today's facts and a lot more.